that sounded mighty cold to me. Amen. I said, let the dead bury the dead. He just wants to go back and bury his father. But I want you to understand something. The Lord wasn't telling him not to bury his father. The phrase there really intimates or suggests that this young man wanted to stay with his father until he died. That's what he's really saying. He's saying, let me live my life. Let me do what I want to do. And then when the time is convenient, then I'll come to you. The Lord says the time to come to me is when it's not convenient. He says, your father one day will die. Your mother one day will die. Your brother will one day die. Your sister will one day die. But let me tell you, you got the best spiritual plan in the world if you come to me today. And I want to offer that same plan to you this morning. There's somebody sitting in this very seat this morning saying, I want to come to God. I want to come to God. But you know what's holding you back? It's not convenient time. I didn't come here to get baptized. I didn't come here to give my life to the Lord. I just came here to serve and then go home. But let me tell you something. You're here because of God's providence. The word providence can be really syllabicated. Pro video. Pro means before. Video means to see. God saw before that you were going to be here this morning. And he saw that you were going to hear the word of God, the gospel message of Jesus Christ. And he's saying this morning that if you reject that message, as the Hebrew writer said, there is nothing left but a fearful watching. If you're not a child of God, every time you close your eyes, you ought to be scared. It should be a fearful watching, because if you die in the state that you're in, heaven will not be your home. Doesn't matter how much you love the Lord, doesn't matter how many church services you've attended, doesn't matter what good deeds you've done in your life. If you're not in Christ's body, if you're not a member of his church, the only church you can read about in Scripture, doesn't matter if you're a good person, doesn't matter if you feed the hungry, doesn't matter if you give your body to be burned, as the Bible says. If you're not in his body, you're not good enough. Isaiah once said, he said, what is all your good works? It's nothing but filthy rags. It's nothing but a menstrual cloth. That's all it is. The last day, somebody's going to say, Lord, Lord, didn't I do many wonderful works? Didn't I cast out demons in your name? The Lord will say, I never knew you. I don't want that to be anybody's reality, because you have the right and you have the privilege this morning to come to Jesus Christ. How do you come to him? The Bible says, he. That's an indistinct pronoun. It doesn't mean, it means basically whoever it is. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. Amen. He that believeth not, meaning that you won't be baptized and you won't be saved, shall be damned. Well, preacher, I just don't understand. I was told this morning all I got to do was say a prayer. Say, Lord, come into my heart. I heard that this morning on the way to church. Well-known minister on TV. Did pretty good up to that point. Then he said, all you have to do is say, Lord, come into my heart. I'll give anybody $1 million right now if you can find that passage in your Bible. I'll give it to you. If I ain't got it, I'll wait till I get it. You won't find the passage that said, Lord, come into my heart. You won't find it. But you will find what I just quoted, Mark 16, 15, and 16. You will find in Acts chapter 2, verse 37. Men and brethren, what shall we do? And Peter didn't say this prayer, come into my heart. Peter said, repent and be baptized, every one of you, for the remission of your sins. And you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Brothers and sisters, I've said enough. If you are a sincere child of God, if you desire to be in the kingdom of Christ right now, you know what you have to do. Give the word of God, believe with all your heart, repent of your sins, confess Jesus Christ, and then be baptized. Washing away your sins. It's not what you do, it's what God does.
Amen.
Acts chapter 8, Bible says there were two men. Philip was in the chariot with an Ethiopian eunuch. Since this was Black History Month, the Ethiopian eunuch was a black man.
Amen.
Those who want to say, well, there ain't no black people in the Bible, Ethiopian is in Africa. As a matter of fact, he's one of the five sons of Ham, and Ham was a black man. You know he was a black man because his name is Ham. Bible says he began to read, and he didn't even read the New Testament. He read the book of Isaiah. The Ethiopian looked at Philip and said, "His water would have hindered me." He says, "If you believe," the Bible says, "I believe." The Bible says they got out of the chariot, and Philip didn't turn to him and say this prayer. The Bible says they went both into the water. The Ethiopian eunuch came up, the Bible says he was rejoicing. Philip was called up, spiritually called up, and sent somewhere else. Brothers and sisters, I've said enough. If you are a child of God already and you need prayer, don't be ashamed to ask for prayer. Confession is good. Confession. We ought to live a life of confession. If you haven't learned anything from these series of lessons, learn that God wants you to be in a lifestyle of confession. Pray to God. Say, "God, I have sinned." Be like David. God said, "Now I ought to kill you for that sin, David. You want to die on the spot." But guess what God says? God says, "I put that sin away." Now, just because God put the sin away doesn't mean God won't give you consequences.
Amen.
Sin carries consequences.
Amen.
But spiritually speaking, David could have been forgiven. And he was. And so if you're a child of God, a member of the Lord's church already, you can ask for prayers with them. Let's do that right now as we stand and sing the song of invitation.